We're back and you're watching Live at 9. Our next guest is a music icon, a multiple Grammy winner with nearly 30 albums to his name.
Oh, he has been busy. In addition to his own solo work, Jim Lauderdale has written numerous hits for everybody, from George Strait to George Jones, Patti Loveless, the Dixie Chicks, you name it.
And he is here in Memphis for one night only on tour in support of his latest album, London Southern.
Love that album name.
So glad to have you here.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Before we get into anything, George Strait has some great words to say about you. How mind-blowing was that for you?
That was very, very nice. He's a great guy, and I've been real lucky to have, I think he's done 14 songs of mine.
Wow.
He says you are an amazing songwriter.
Well, George.
So when you're writing, where do you get your inspiration, and what comes first, the lyrics or the music?
Sometimes both. But wow. Usually for me, the melodies come first.
Okay, and, like they just come to you, like when
yes.
you're sleeping?
Sometimes right before I'm falling asleep.
Wow.
When I dream, usually sometimes I'll think of something, but if I don't have a recording device next to me or before I'm falling asleep, I go, must record. but they come at odd times.
All right, the other part of that then, the lyrics. Where do you find these stories? Are these personal? Where do you get them?
You know, all sorts of places. Sometimes it's in conversation with people, and I'll hear something. I'll think, wait a minute.
So wait a minute. You said we need Mary Beth and I need to watch what we say around you.
We need to watch what we say.
There you go.
You never know.
We need a co-credit there for that hit.
Has there ever been a time when you've written a song and kind of in your mind you have it going one way and somebody records it and they do it a little different?
You know, I've been asked that before. Sometimes people say, have you ever been disappointed?
Yeah.
And I'm always so thrilled when somebody records one of my songs. Yeah. I've never been unhappy with it. Yeah.
Very quickly,
it's like giving your baby
tell
away.
Us about the latest album. What's the feel of it for those who haven't heard it yet?
I did a record over in England several years ago and used the band of a guy named Nick Lowe, who's and actually years ago I came through and played at the New Daisy opening up for him.
Yeah.
But I want to put in a plug on a record I'm working on at Royal Studios.
Oh,
I'm going to do one today that I wrote and recorded there at Royal.
And what are you going to do for us right now?
That's what you're going to do right now?
Yes.
That's what you're going to do?
Okay.
Awesome. What's it called?
Way Out is Fine.
All right.
All right.
Jim Lauderdale, do your thing. Glad to have you.
Such a pleasure to have you.
Well, I can't move a shoe up a mountain without a bit of faith. Looking just how far the baby steps are gonna take. And I can't say that patience is paying off in copious quantities. I can't see the entrance now to the forest from the trees. Way out is fine. A good thing to surely happen in good time. Fine. Until then, we'll please have some of mine. Well, I can't prove that Isaac Newton could sound like Isaac Hayes. And I can't tell you what I'm doing when I don't know what to say. But I can offer consolation when you find yourself in need. When you want to share a ride to where your heart might lead. It's fine. A good thing surely happen in good time. Standing next to you, you're on a different plane.